Good morning, students. Today we are going to see standard 8th, chapter number 9, last phase of struggle for independence. In this chapter, we are going to study Quit India Movement, Underground Movement, and the contribution of Indian National Army. These 3 points we are going to see in this chapter: Quit India Movement, Underground Movement, and contribution of Indian National Army. Act of 1935. Let's see what is the Act of 1935. This act made a provision for the British governed Indian provinces and princely states to form a federation. According to this act, the working of British governed provinces will be handed over to the Indian representatives. If the princely states join the federation, then they would lose their autonomy. Hence, they refused to join. Therefore, the proposal of federal state in the act was not brought into practice. So, according to this act, the working of British government under the provinces will be handed over to the Indian representatives. But if the princely states join the federation, then they would lose their autonomy, due to which they had refused to join the British government. And the proposal of federal state in the act was not brought into practice. Provincial cabinets. The Indian National Congress was not satisfied with the act of 1935, but still decided to take part in the election of provincial legislature provided by the act. As according to the act of 1935 was passed, Government of Indian Act 1935, under that they had decided to take a part in election for the legislature. In 1937, elections were held in 11 provinces in the country. So, the elections had been taken place in our country in 1937 in 11 provinces. Among these, Indian National Congress gained majority over 8 provinces. So, from 11 provinces, the Indian National Congress, they had got majority of votes from 8 provinces and came to power. In other 3 provinces, none of the party could achieve majority, and therefore mixed cabinet was formed. So, as from 11 provinces, 8 provinces had been won by Indian National Congress and left 3, here no any majority had party had taken place, due to which a mixed cabinet was formed in that part. The cabinet ministers of Indian National Congress did useful work for the people, such as release of political prisoners from jail, introduction of basic education, prohibition of liquor, measures undertaken to improve condition of the Dalits, passing of act giving debt relief to the farmers, etc. So, under the cabinet, the duties which was given to the cabinet ministers of the Indian National Congress was to release the political prisoners from jail, and also to give introduction of basic education to all children, and to prohibit the liquor. Liquor means beer. So that the unwanted liquids will come under the liquor. Measures undertaken to improve conditions of Dalits. So, the different measures they had started to improve the condition of Dalits under the guidance of Indian National Congress ministers, and also they had passed to an act giving debt relief to the farmers. If the loss of farms are done, if any disaster had taken place, so the debt of the farmers will be released. No any debt will be kept on the farmers. This all were the works which was done by the cabinet ministers of Indian National Congress, and it had been useful for our country. Cripps Mission. During the Second World War, England supported America against Japan. The Japanese army reached the eastern borders of India. The British realized that if Japan attacks India, then they will need cooperation from the Indians. Hence, the British Prime Minister Winston Churchill sent Sir Stafford Cripps to India. So, hear about the Cripps Mission they had given. What is the Cripps Mission? As during the Second World War, the England supported America against Japan. England and America, England country had supported America to fight against Japan. So Japanese army reached the eastern coast, eastern boundaries of India. So British realized that if Japan attacks India, then they will need cooperation from the Indians. So they had accepted to support the British people, due to which they need cooperation to fight against the Japanese people. Hence, the British Prime Minister Winston Churchill sent Sir Stafford Cripps to India to solve or to discuss with the Indian peoples to support them for the Japanese war or for the Second World War. In March 1942, he put up a proposal of India in front of the Indians, but none of the political party was satisfied with the this proposal. So, the under the Cripps mission, the Stafford Cripps, in March 1942, he put a proposal in front of the India, in front of the Indian people, and the proposal was rejected by the Indian people, by our Indian political parties. The Indian National Congress rejected the proposal since there was no clear mention of complete independence, as under the Cripps mission, they had not declared that if we will support the British people to fight against the Japanese people, they had not said that we will release India and we will go back to our country. So, no any party was supporting to British. The Indian National Congress rejected the proposal since there was no clear mention of complete independence. Since there was no mention of creation of Pakistan, the Muslim League also rejected the Cripps mission. So, as under the Muslim League, they want their separate country. So, it was not mentioned that the Pakistan as a second country, they will get a different provinces will be created for the Muslim people. So, the Cripps mission was rejected. Second World War and Indian National Congress. The Second World War began in Europe in 1939. The then Viceroy, Lord Lillingthau, declared that India has joined the war on the side of the British. So, Indian people, they had joined the war against the European people, and they had taken the support of British people. England claimed that it is fighting to save democracy in Europe. So, in the England, they had claimed that we are fighting to secure our Europe province. The Indian National Congress demanded that if the claim was true, then England should immediately grant freedom to India. So England had said that if it is true, so the freedom should be granted to Indian people. England refused to fulfill this demand, and therefore the provincial ministers of Indian National Congress resigned in November 1939. So, as according to the refuse of England, as they had refused the demand to relieve the India and go back to their country, due to which the Indian National Congress, they had resigned in November 1939. Quit India movement. After the Cripps mission, the Indian National Congress decided to start an intense movement for attaining independence. The Working Committee of the Congress passed a resolution on 14 July 1942 at Wardha. So, after the Cripps mission, the Indian National Congress, they had decided to start an intense movement attaining towards the independence. So, under this, the Working Committee of the Congress, they had passed a resolution on 14 July 1942 at Wardha. The resolution demanded that the British rule in India be ended immediately and India should be given independence. So, under this resolution, they had demanded that the British rule should be ended and the India should be declared as independent. If this demand was not fulfilled, then the Indian National Congress want to start a non-violent movement for freedom of India. So, the Indian National Congress, They had warned the British government that if they are not going to give us independence, so again we are going to non-violent movement start for the freedom of country, India. Quit India resolution. On 7th August 1942, the session of Indian National Congress was held at Gwalior Tank, Kranti Maidan in Mumbai. Maulana Abul Kalam Azad was the president of the session. So, a session was taken place at Gawali Tank near Kranti Maidan in Mumbai under the guidance of Maulana Abul Kalam Azad on 7th August 1942 by Indian National Congress. The British should leave India. The resolution passed by Congress Working Committee at Wardha was to be finally approved in the Mumbai session. So under this Mumbai session, what they had attended the meeting? They had arranged the meeting for the complete independence of our country. So the Britishers should leave India and they have to go back to their own countries and they have to declare the India as independent. So to take approval of for this, a Mumbai session was arranged. On 8th August, the resolution of Quit India put forth by Jawaharlal Nehru got passed with great majority. It was also decided to start a nationwide non-violent agitation under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhiji said, "Every one of you should from this moment onwards consider yourself a free man or woman and behave like a citizen of free India. We shall either free India or die in the attempt." Gandhiji made an inspiration appeal to the public to be ready to sacrifice with the feeling do or die. So, under this, on 8th August, a resolution of Quit India movement had been started by Jawaharlal Nehru. As he was with great majority, he got passed with the Indian National Congress. And also, it was decided to start a nationwide movement. As under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, Gandhiji, he said that up to when we have to feel ourselves that this is our country and we are citizens of this country. So, you have to be inspire yourself and you have to be inspirational and you have to appeal to the public that you should be ready to sacrifice your life for our country. Sacrificing feeling should be in your mind that whether we will do it or whether we will die, but the work will be completed. Beginning of People's Movement. The news of arrest of important leaders of Indian National Congress spread out all over the country. The angry mob took out procession at various places. So, a movement started in our country by some important leaders of our country had been arrested by the British people, and due to which a mob with angry mood, a mob they had to procession on roads. At various places, even the police lathi charge had open firing on the public, but still people were not afraid. As open firing had been done, different lathi charge had taken place, but the people's anger was not stopping. The demand was to leave the leaders. The agitators attacked some places, jails, police stations, railway stations, etc., which symbolized the suppressive policy of the British. So here they had given that as the Indian people, they had attacked on many different jails, some police stations, railway stations, and it had shown that how we are going against to our British, as there is no any demand to put in front of the British. Just what they want complete independence for the country. They tried to take control of government offices. In Maharashtra, the young and old struggled with determination and boundless courage at places like Chimur, Ashti, Yauli, Mahad, Gargoti, etc., and made the struggle immortal. So, they had tried their best and they had took control of government offices in Maharashtra. The young and old struggled with determination, the boundless courage of the people. It had been in different places a very good response by the Indian people had been seen like Chimur, Ashti, Yavli, Mahad, Gargoti. These were the places where struggle had taken a good role here people had played. Let us know individual satyagraha. The British government was constantly neglecting the demands, hence the Indian National Congress decided to start anti-war propaganda. For this, it was decided that instead of a collective movement, every single person should disobey the laws. This was known as individual satyagraha. Acharya Vinoba Bhave was the first satyagrahi of individual satyagraha. He was followed by nearly 25,000 satyagrahis who accepted imprisonment for their participation. So, this is a little information which was given about Acharya Vinoba Bhave. Do you know inspirational accounts of brave children? The school students also contributed in the freedom movement. Just not women, men, but also the small children, they had participated in the freedom movement for our country. At Nandurbar, the school children under the leadership of Shirish Kumar carried out procession holding the tricolor flag. The slogan was of Vande Mataram was given. The police became furious and opened firing on small children as well. In this firing, Shirish Kumar, Lal Das, Dhansukh Lal, Shashidhar, Ghansham, the school children became martyr. So, as the British people, the British army, they had not seen whether they are children or whether they are the young ones or what. Just they had taken a open firing on them and many different small children, they had been a martyr for our country. Underground movement. At the end of 1942, the public movement got a new turn. The leadership of this movement went into hands of the young socialist activist Jay Prakash Narayan, Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia, Chotu Bhai Puranik, Achut Rao Patwardhan, Aruna Asif Ali, Yusuf Meher Ali, Sucheta Kripalini, S.M. Joshi, Shirubhau Lime, N.G. Gore, Yashwant Rao Chauhan, Vasant Dada Patil, Mangan Lal Bagdi, Usha Mehta, such leaders were in the forefront. So these all are the leaders who had went. These are the leaders who had went on to the hands of young socialist activists as activists in our country, who had played a good role for the freedom struggle. The activists had disrupted the transport and communication as well as the government machinery by causing the breakdown of railway routes. So, they had tried to stop the machinery, the working of the British government by breaking down the routes of the railway and by cutting the telephone lines, by blowing up the bridges and many different things. The impact of the movement was seen all over India. Hemu Kalyani in Sindh province tried to destroy the railway along with his companions when he received the news of passing of railway carrying British troops and supplies. The court punished him to be hanged to death. So, as one person who had tried to go against towards the British government, he had been hanged to death as he had tried to stop a railway who was carrying the British troops and supplies of Britishers. So he had been caught and he had put to hang to the death. Bhai Kotwal's Azad Dast in Karjat Taluka of modern day Raigarh district, General Awari Lal Sena in Nagpur, such groups made the government helpless and witless for months. In Mumbai, Vittal Zawadi, Usha Mehta and her companion established a secret transmission center named Azad Radio. Patriotic songs were sung on it. News of agitation in the country were broadcasted on it. Patriotic speeches were telecasted. This gave encouragement to the agitators. Such transmission center operated at Kolkata, Delhi and Pune from some period of time. So, the movement had not stopped. As through the Azad Radio, many different patriotic songs, different speeches had been telecasted to give the encouragement to the Indian people and not to stop the freedom movement. So, not only in Mumbai, but also in Kolkata, Delhi and Pune and many different places, the different Azad Hind Radio or Azad Radio telecast was taking place. So the encouragement should be done in all over the parts of our country. establishment of parallel government at some places in the country, British officers were driven out, the people's government was established. These are called parallel government. So the definition of parallel government they are given, that at some places the British officers were driven out and the people's government was established. People's government. So it is only known as the parallel government. Parallel government were formed in district of Midnapur in Bengal, Balia and Azamgarh in Uttar Pradesh and Purnia in Bihar. So these are the parallel government where had been allotted at these places. In Satara district of Maharashtra in 1942, Kranti Singh Nana Patil brought an end to the British government and established parallel government. At Kundal, under the leadership of Kranti Grani GD allies Bapu Lad, Tufan Sena was established. Through its medium, collection of taxes, maintenance of law and order, punishment of to criminals, such work was done by the parallel government. So, this all are the work which was taken by, as like Tufan Sena had been established by GD allies Kranti Grani GD allies Bapu Lad. So, under this, the medium collection, through its medium, the collection of taxes, maintenance of law and order, punishment to the criminals and different works was taken out by the parallel government for Indian people. People started accepting the verdicts passed by the People's Court appointed by the parallel government. Opposition to money lenders, prohibition on liquor, spread of literacy, opposition to caste distinction. Many such constructive work was done by the government, by this government. Due to it, parallel government became a source of inspiration for the public. So, the parallel government had been helpful for the Indian people, due to which it had been become an inspiration for the public. So as they had stopped prohibition of liquor, spread of illiteracy, they had tried to make control over all these problems. So parallel government had played a good role during freedom of movement. Importance of Quit India Movement. The 1942 movement took up the form of a nationwide agitation to fulfill the objectives of gaining independence. Lakhs of Indians made unlimited sacrifices. Many sacrificed their life. The number of people participating in the struggle was so huge that even all the prisons in the whole of the country were not enough to contain them. The patriotic songs composed by Sani Guruji, Rashtra Sant Tukdoji Maharaj and others increased the enthusiasm of the agitators. This nationwide movement is also called August Kranti. So, as due to Azad Radio and different ways, many people they had been encouraged and they were ready to sacrifice their life. So unlimited people they were ready to sacrifice their life, and also the British government will be unable to capture or to take the people to the prisoners, as the jails were shorter and the people's encouragement was more. Indian National Army, Azad Hind Sena, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose took phenomenal efforts for gaining independence of India on the eastern borders of India. Thousands of Indians stood in readiness to fight against the British. All these soldiers belonged to Azad Hind Sena. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was their leader. So Azad Hind Sena had been started for gaining the independence of India. Different thousands of Indian people they stood to readiness to fight against the British. And also, the soldiers belong to Azad Hind Sena were ready to sacrifice their life for freedom movement of our country. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, he was the leader of Azad Hind Sena. Subhash Chandra Bose was an important leader of Indian National Congress. He graced the position of President of Congress twice as per his opinion. While England was engaged in Second World War, the Indians should take advantage of it and make the movement more intense. If necessary, India should seek the help of the enemies of England, but there arose differences of opinion between him and other senior leaders of Congress. As a result, Subhash Chandra Bose resigned from the position of president. As Subhash Chandra Bose, he has put his thought in front of the Indian National Congress that when the British company is busy while fighting with England, at that time we have to take the advantage of it and we have to take the support of the enemies of British and we have to fight against the British people. But it had not been supported by the leaders of Indian National Congress, due to which Subhash Chandra Bose, he had resigned the president position. To place his views in front of the people, he founded a party known as Forward Bloc. So after that, he had started Forward Bloc Party. The foundation, he had founded the party as Forward Bloc. Through his speeches, Netaji appealed to the Indians to revolt against the British rule. Due to it, the government imprisoned him. Subhash Chandra Bose went on fast unto death in the prison, due to which the British government interned him in his residence. From there, he escaped the rescues. In April 1941, he reached Germany. There, he founded the Free Indian Center. From the Berlin radio station in Germany, he appealed to the Indian people to join in an armed struggle. During this period, Ras Bihari Bose invited Subhash Chandra Bose to Japan. So, through his speeches, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, he had started encouraging the people against the British rule, and due to which the British government, he thought to imprison the Subhash Chandra Bose. So, as he got the news, he went on fast unto death in the prison. So, he went out from it, and he went to, in April 1941, he reached Germany. And from there, he started Free Indian Center from the Berlin radio station from Germany. After that, Ras Bihari Bose, he invited Subhash Chandra Bose to come to Japan. Formation of Indian National Army. Ras Bihari Bose was staying in Japan since 1915. He had organized the Indian patriots living in countries of Southeast Asia and established the organization named Indian Independence League. So as from 1915, Ras Bihari Bose, he was staying in Japan, and many different Indian patriots he had created from the Southeast Asia and established a Indian Independence League in 1942. Japan conquered the territory in Southeast Asia, which were controlled by the British. Thousands of Indian soldiers and officers in British Army there fell into the hands of Japan. Ras Bihari Bose, with the help of Captain Mohan Singh, formed a battalion of this Indian prisoners of war. It was named as Indian National Army. So, with the help of Captain Mohan Singh, he formed a battalion of this Indian imprisoners of war, and he named it as Indian National Army. That is Azad Hind Sena. Later, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose led the Indian National Army. In October 1943, Netaji established Azad Hind Government in Singapore. Shah Nawaz Khan, Jagannath Bhosle, Dr. Lakshmi Swaminathan, Guru Baksh Singh, Dhillon, Prem Kumar Sehgal, etc. were his chief associates. Captain Lakshmi Swaminathan was the commander of Rani of Jhansi Regiment. Netaji appealed to the Indian people, "You give me blood and I will give you independence." So, by the words of Netaji, he said that, "Tum mujhe khoon do, main tumhe azadi dunga." These were the words which was used by Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, and he tried to take the support of Indian people to fight against the British. Achievements of Indian National Army. In November 1943, Japan conquered Andaman and Nicobar Islands and handed them over to Azad Hind government. Netaji renamed them as Shaheed or Swarajya, respectively. In 1944, Indian National Army captured the Arakan province in Myanmar, post on the eastern border of Assam, were captured in the same period. The campaign of Imphal remained incomplete because Japan stopped helping the Indian National Army. But in adverse circumstances, soldiers of Indian National Army were dedicatedly fighting. But in the same period, Japan accepted defeat. On 18th August 1945, Subhash Chandra Bose died in a plane accident. On this background, the soldiers of Indian National Army had to lay down their arms. Thus ended the thrilling phase of the Indian National Army. So, with the death of Subhash Chandra Bose, the phase of Indian National Army came to an end. The powerful person had been died, due to which it had been given a bad effect to our independence. So, in 18 August 1945, Subhash Chandra Bose, he died in a plane accident. Before it, he tried to make control over the parts of our country with the help of Japan. As in Japan stopped helping the Indian National Army, due to which the soldiers of Indian National Army were dedicatedly fighting against the British government. Later, the British government charged the officers of Indian National Army with the present Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Bhulabhai Desai, Tej Bahadur Sapre. These expert lawyers defended them, but the military tribunal held the officers guilty and they were sentenced to life imprisonment. Therefore, there was severe unrest against the British government in the minds of Indian people. Finally, the British government had to suspend the punishments given by the military tribunal. As with the help of Rasbihari Bose, he tried to control the situation, but it was out of control, due to which the officers, the Indian National Army with present had been captured and put into the jail. As the lawyers, they had tried to defend them. So finally, the British government had to suspend the punishment which was given to the military tribunal, and they were released. Revolts of Indian Navy and Air Force. The Navy and Air Force soldiers, with the inspiration from Indian National Army, caused discontent against the British government. It burst out on the British war ship Talwar in Mumbai on 18 February 1946. The soldiers unfurled the tricolour flag on the British warship. They raised slogans against the British government. So, under this, the Navy and Air Force soldiers, with the inspiration from the Indian National Army, that caused against to the British government, it burst out and in Mumbai, 18 February 1946, the soldiers unfurled the tricolour flag on the British warship. They raised slogans against the British government. Also, the British government sent army to open fire on the naval soldiers. The rebels also made counter-attack with firing. So, as from one side, the British government the British government sent army to open fire on the naval soldiers of our Indian soldiers. Against to this, the Indian soldiers also opened fire on the British army. The workers and common people extended their support to the naval soldiers. So, the different common people and the workers, they had supported the Indian national our Indian soldiers to fight against the British in open firing. Finally, with the mediation of Sardar Vallabhai Patel, the naval soldiers laid down their arms. So, as by the words of Sardar Vallabhai Patel, the naval soldiers, they had let down their firing and the firing had been stopped. To support the uprising of naval soldiers, the Air Force officers from Delhi, Lahore, Karachi, Ambala, Meerut, etc. went on strike. These revolts were a clear indication that the sentiments of discontent against the rulers had reached the climax. In this way, the period between 1940 to 1946 shook the foundation of British power in India. Through the Quit India movement, the severe discontent of Indian people against the British was expressed. Army, Navy and Air Force was the backbone of British power. They were also now opposing the British. Due to this incident, the British rulers realized that they will not be able to empower India for a long period of time. As the Army, Navy and Air Force, this were the backbone of British power, but they were stopped supporting the British government and they had started supporting the Indian National Congress, due to which the British rulers, they had realized that now it is the time to empower India and for a long period of time, and we will not be able to continue a rule on as like of Indian country, and they have to go back to their country. Read the chapter again from first page, from page number 40 to 44, and try to understand the content. self reading will help you to understand the topic easily. So here in 1935, in this chapter we have seen that into secrecy the government had passed an act against the British in 1935. In 1937 we had seen that the election were held to the provincial legislature in 11 provinces. In 1939 we had seen that Second World War began in Europe. In 1941, in April, Subhash Chandra Bose reached Germany, and in March, Sir Stafford Cripps put up a proposal of dominant states in front of the Indians. Also, we had seen in March, Sir Stafford Cripps put up a proposal of dominant states in front of the Indians. On 14 July 1942, the Congress Working Committee passed a resolution of Wardha, which demanded the end of the British rule in India. And also we had seen on 7th August, the Indian National Congress session was held at Gwalior Tank at the Kranti Maidan in Mumbai. In 18th August, Quit India resolution, which was put forth by Jawaharlal Nehru, got passed with great majority. Also, the Kranti Senana Patil ended the British government in the Satara district of Maharashtra and established the parallel government. About parallel government, we had seen in this chapter. In 1943 October, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose established the Azad Hind government in Singapore. In November, Japan conquered Andaman and Nicobar Islands and handed them over to Azad Hind government. In 1944, we had seen Indian National Army captured the Arakan province in Myanmar. In 1945, on 18th August, Subhash Chandra Bose died in a plane accident. This were the main points which we had seen in this chapter, the last phase of struggle of independence. Read chapter carefully and complete the given exercise. Thank you.